Welcome to the CAD Office Training Guide Series for FDOT Connect. I'm Candy Daffin, CAD Support Specialist. Today, I'll be going through the Automated Quantities Workflow Training Guide. In this series of videos, I will take you step by step through each exercise from the guide. Today, we'll start with Chapter 4 of the guide. Let's begin. The topics we will cover include where to find and launch the Summary Reports Builder tool, how to create and edit the signature page for the estimated quantities report, and how to use the Summary Reports Builder tool to create the estimated quantities report PDF. Before we look into the Summary Reports Builder, let's go ahead and go through exercise 4.1. Because the estimated quantities report PDF needs a signature page, and the signature page is in a different format than the summary reports, we need to use a slightly different approach to create this page. One of the things we'll need to include in our signature page is an image of the engineer of record seal. Since it needs to go into an Excel file instead of a CAD file, we need to create an image of the seal. We'll start by editing the seal cell that is provided in the roadway folder of the dataset. On a live project, this file may have already been created for the signatures of the plan set, but if it hasn't, you can copy the seals.cell file from the FDOT Connect Cells folder to the project roadway folder and edit it there. So let's go to File, Open, and change the file format to .cel. Then open the seals.cell file. Once the file opens, locate the model for the PE seal and adjust the view. If your seals haven't already been set up, you'll need to change the engineer name and number, so we'll go ahead and make those changes here. To do that, on the Open Roads Modeling workflow, select the Drawing Production tab. Then, in the Edit Text tool group, select Edit Text. Then click on Signature Name. And I'll change that to Luke S. Walker, our imaginary Jedi engineer of record. Next, we need to change the PE number, but since it's a data field, let's use the single Enter Data Field tool. In the bottom right corner of the tool group is the More button. Pull that down and select Fill in Single Enter Data Field. That way, we won't affect the field and the number of characters will stay the same. Let's enter the value as 99991 and click OK. Now that the seal looks right, let's put a shape around it to help us print to a known scale. In the Drawing tab, in the Attributes tool group, change the level to Plot Border DP. That is a non-plotting level that will give us a shape we can snap to get our print area. So let's use the Place Block tool to create a square. In the Placement tool group near the middle, make sure the Polygon Tools is set to Place Block. We can click anywhere in the file. We'll move it once it's drawn. I keep my AccuDraw coordinates docked at the bottom of my screen. If you don't have it active, you can just type AccuDraw in the search bar to get the dialog. Click in the X value and type :3, then press Enter. Then type :3 again and enter in the Y value. This should create a 3-inch square. Now we want to center this on our seal, so on the Manipulate tool group, select Move. Then in the Snaps, select Center. Tentative on the square, then data point to accept. Select the Center Snap again, and tentative on one of the circles around the seal. You may have to click the tentative a couple of times to get it to select the correct shape. Once it locks to the center, data point to accept the center of the seal. With everything centered, we can now print an image and we'll know that the square is drawn at 3 inches. Since we're creating an image, though, we don't want it to have a black background. To change the background, go to File, Settings, File, Color Table. Then double-click on the bottom right square with the letter B in it. Change the tab to the List view and scroll to the bottom to select the white option. Then click OK and click Attach. Then we can click the back button and we're ready to create our image. Now we can use the square to create a fence. In the Selection tool group, click the Fence Tools. You can use the tentative snaps to click to the corners, or you can change the selection to Element and just select the square. Once we have the fence created, we can go to Print. On the Quick Access toolbar at the top, click Print. We'll change the setting to JPEG.PLTCFG. Set the printer and paper size to max. Make sure the area is set to fence. Then in the scale size area, type in 3. Then click Print to File. That should create a JPG file. The name should match the model name, and it should go into the same folder as the file it was created from. In this case, we get a file named PEseal.jpg in the Roadway folder. You can check it out by going to the FDOT tab and clicking on Explore Directory's Current Workset. It should open the Roadway folder, and you can scroll down and see the image file there. Double-click and it will open with your default photo viewer. Now we're ready to start editing the signature sheet. This Excel template is provided in the FDOTConnect workspace that is set up for the signature page. When a new project is created from the Zero Workset template, the signature page template should be included in the Calculations folder. If for any reason that file is not already in the Calculations folder, you can locate it and copy it from the FDOTConnect Asset Manager folder and place it in your Calculations folder before editing it. Since we're in the Explorer window, let's browse up a level to the Calculations folder and locate the file eqrsignature.xlsx. Double-click on the file and it will open in Excel. Notice that when I open the file, it's split and not showing on one page. That's because my default print settings don't have an 11 by 17 option. To fix that, all I have to do is go to File, Print, and change the printer to a different option that includes 11 by 17. Now I see the whole page, I can click the back button and the template shows on one page now. Keep in mind that this is a template. All the text in red italics is a placeholder to indicate what information belongs in that location. It should either be deleted or replaced. When you fill in the project information, make sure to change the text back to black and normal text. I'll type in the information just like it's shown in the training guide, starting with the project number, then the contract number, and I'll fill in the project description. Then I can jump down to the EOR address section and replace that text with the address and EOR name and PE number. Once that's all filled out, I can delete the seal graphic placeholder text and delete the EOR name and date timestamp text. When the EOR signs and seals this page, that's the location where the digital signature stamp should be placed. Next, we want to put in our seal image we just created. The merged cell should be 3 inches square, so when we insert the image, it should fit in the cell perfectly. If it doesn't, we can adjust the rows or columns as needed. Click in the cell, then select Insert Pictures, Insert Picture from this device, and let's browse to our project. And once we're in the roadway folder, find the PEseal.jpg. Select it and click OK. Once the image is placed, right-click and check the picture format. Sometimes the height and width doesn't come through as exactly 3 inches, but you can change it to 3 inches here, and it should help it fit within the cell and make sure that it prints to the correct size. Now I've got all my project information updated and the placeholder text cleaned up, I can save this file. And then I'll also need to save it as a PDF. The Summary Reports Builder is configured to insert the signature page PDF as the first sheet in the Estimated Quantities report when it finds it in the Estimates folder. So click File, Save As, then let's browse to the Project Estimates folder. Click on the path and you should be able to navigate up a level, and select the Estimates folder. Then change the Save As type to PDF. Once the location, file name, and file type are correct, check the box for Open File After Publishing and click Save. The PDF of the signature page should open, and we can check to make sure that everything looks okay. And now we're ready to move on to the next exercise. Before we start on exercise 4.2, let's take a quick look at the Summary Reports Builder. Let's go back to the QTD SRD02 file and start from there. Summary Reports Builder is another tool that was developed for FDOTConnect by the CAD office to work with Open Roads Designer. This tool takes all of the Excel quantity summary reports and combines them into the Estimated Quantities Report PDF. Let's launch it first from within the Quantity Takeoff Manager. The Create PDF button is a shortcut to launch the Summary Reports Builder tool. The name and version number is at the top of the dialog. If you run into any problems, knowing the version number may be helpful in troubleshooting. Then you'll find the input and output directories. They should default to the Project Calculations folder and the Project Estimates folder when you launch the tool from the Quantity Takeoff Manager. In the center, you'll find a list of all the Excel files within the spreadsheet input directory specified above. It will automatically ignore the signature sheet file, but all the other Excel files will be listed here. You can select them individually by clicking in the checkboxes, or you can use the selection buttons at the bottom to select files. Make sure to only select files that are named in the same format as the list in the Quantity Takeoff Manager, otherwise you'll get an error. The Summary Reports Builder uses the same resource files as the Quantity Takeoff Manager, so if the names don't match, it won't be able to process the files. You can click the checkbox for Open Output File if you want the PDF to open automatically when it's created. Once you've selected all the files that need to be included in your Estimated Quantities Report PDF, click Create and the files will be processed. And of course, when you're done, you can click the Close button. You can also launch the Summary Reports Builder from outside of MicroStation. In the FDOTConnect desktop folder, there is an icon for Summary Reports Builder. You can double-click to launch it from the folder. When you launch it this way, the input and output directory paths are not populated, and you'll have to click the Browse button to navigate to the project and specify the Calculations folder for the input and the Estimates folder for the output. Now let's jump back into the exercise from the QTDSRD02 file. You can actually do this process from any file within the project. But before we create our PDF, we need a bit more data to include in our estimated quantities report. From within the QTDSRD02, you could generate the summary reports for all of the tables on the project, or in this case, you can copy the files from the complete folder provided in the calculations folder of the dataset. To save time, I'll just copy the files into the calculations folder. Back in the Quantity Takeoff Manager, let's click the Create PDF button to launch the Summary Reports Builder. Double-check the input and output paths and verify that they're going to the right folders. Take a look at the list of Excel Summary Report files. There should be a few more files in the dataset now than the ones we created in the previous exercises, though you may have more or less files on an active project, depending on the scope of the project. All the files appear to be named correctly, and we want to include all of them in our Estimated Quantities Report PDF. So click the button for Select All, and check the box for Open Output File. Then click Create. Notice you'll also get the warning message here, just like we did with Quantity Takeoff Manager. If you have an older version of the Estimated Quantities Report that you want to save, make sure you do that before you click OK, or you'll overwrite any existing files. Depending on how many Excel files you have and the amount of worksheets in each file, it may take a few minutes to process. When it finishes, though, the PDF will open. Notice that because we had already saved the signature page PDF in the Estimates folder, it picked that page up and included it. If it's not already open, you can open the Bookmarks panel and see that each summary report has its own bookmark. You can click on any of these and it will take you straight to that report. You can also use the Edit Find tool to search on any word, phrase, or number within the PDF. The pages are all numbered, and each page has a date and timestamp so you'll know when the PDF was created. We can close the PDF, and that's the end of this exercise. Thank you for joining me today for the CAD Office series for FDOTConnect. This was Chapter 4 of the Automated Quantities Workflow.